entering menu narration pop-up. Do you want to disable menu narrate? Press.
Take all that just another game stuff and throw it out. The eyes of the nation are on this field today, and that's what these players live for. To New Orleans and the iconic Caesars Superdome, the long-term home of the All-State Sugar Bowl, which this year, of course, is part of the college football playoff. We're expecting a full house this afternoon. We've got an anticipated clash here, as we'll see a team from the ACC, the Wake Forest Demon Deacons, taking on the 13th-ranked team in the land, the LSU Tigers. For EA Sports College Football, I'm Chris Fowler, here in the booth with Kirk Herbstreit. Now that we've talked long enough, Kirk, let's get this game going. Inside the 5-yard line. Gets it to the 25-yard line, and that's where they'll start the drive. The Tigers offense is up first today. And here comes that star wide receiver. He's got the bounce, the aura. He walks on the field with some swag saying, I'm the man, and I know it.
Oh, he certainly does, and you know what? He probably should. It's founded in all the hard work that he puts in, the dedication in the summertime during practice. You can see some of the defensive backs watch him as he warms up, studying him, because they know it's going to be a long day trying to deal with this receiver. Chris, is it possible to be DBU and wide receiver U at the same time? I think the LSU fans think it's possible. They always seem to have great defensive backs, and they always have pass catchers that just show up and show out week after week, year after year.
So the offense with a first and 10 now, the football placed exactly at midfield. Dropping back, it's Nussmeier. And that pass rush has trapped him. It's a sack.
This is exactly how you can slow down the momentum and the rhythm of an offense. You got to get some tackles for a loss and some sacks. This time, they come. getting after that quarterback.
Quarterback wants to throw it on second down. Caught over the middle. It's Taylor. Tackle finally made. That's a very solid gain, but not close to first down yardage yet. So the ball at midfield. Now the offense facing a third and long. Fires this one deep middle. Oh, and he's got it. Big gain inside the 25.
That is great arm strength and accuracy by this quarterback. And let's not forget the wide receiver's job of bringing it in for that big gain.
This LSU offense is moving quickly down the field. Looking to throw it from the red zone. Grab down the middle. It's Taylor. And he takes it in for the score. Touchdown, Bayou Bengals.
That kind of play is almost impossible to defend. When the quarterback is throwing the ball with that kind of accuracy and timing, and the receiver runs a route like this, good luck trying to stop it. So maybe this is a great start for this combination, this quarterback and receiver, for a big day.
Here comes the point after attempt. PAT is good. They jump in front 7-0. Here's the kickoff team now, set to boot this one away. And the return starts from inside the 20. Not much on the return. They'll stop up at the 24. Good coverage. So the Wake Forest Demon Deacons offense makes their way onto the field for their first possession. Well, it's not easy to narrow down the impact players to just a few guys, Kirk, but what do you expect from them today?
Well, we got guys that can make plays as well as anybody in the country on both sides of the ball. That's why I think this matchup is so exciting. Two good teams with great individual players.
Off the play fake, looking to throw. He'll take a deep shot here. That deep shot is caught for a big gain. Will that holding penalty be a drive killer? Here comes the bunch formation. Looking to throw. It's Bachmeier. Running out of time. Here's a fumble way behind the line of scrimmage. Defense has got the football. Touchdown, Tigers! On the scoop and score.
It's one thing for the defense to be able to create a turnover. It's another thing to be able to pick it up and take it into the end zone yourself.
Now the all-important extra point. The extra point is good, and they stretch the lead a little bit more. Getting set to kick the ball off now. And it's caught from inside the 20. And he's brought down at the 28. That's where the drive will start. Big Four sends the offense back out on the field now. First down, looking to throw the ball. Oh, the pass is picked off. Big takeaway, now looking for a big return. Past the 10. Return to pick 6. Touchdown, LSU. And a pick 6, a monster play by this defense here, Kirk.
That defender showed a lot of athletic ability there with the ball in his hands. I wouldn't be surprised if the head coach watching that thought about maybe giving him some reps as a returner after that touchdown.
And they'll set up for the PAT. Yeah, the extra point, and the lead now 21-0. Kickoff team on the field getting set now. Kickoff is fielded inside the 20. He's brought down at the 28. That's where the drive will start. The Wake Forest offense back out on the field now. It'll be interesting to see if this quarterback can bounce back through a pick six in the last possession. The gain is 2 yards, so it's second and 8.
Christina, the spread era over the years has always grown offensively, but what I've been always impressed with defenses that really build their defense to play in space still have an ability to be sound at the line of scrimmage and defend a running game. It's exactly what we saw right there.
Short completion, a third down play coming up. Ending off on the draw play. Goes backwards, losing 3 yards there. And the Demon Deacons will line up to punt it away.
Man, the defensive coordinator has to be fired up about this play. The thing that he has to love is that his defense and their technique was right on point. They didn't lose their leverage. They stayed with the play and didn't just go after the quarterback.
And he's going to head out of bounds, but not before picking up some good yardage on the return. And here comes that LSU offense back onto the field. The last possession was a passing game clinic. They moved it right down for a touchdown. Can they keep it going? Fresh set of downs for the offense. First down. Hand off to the back. Got the first down. Now looking for more. Second effort. Their defense cannot stop him short of the marker.
Chris, I know when we think about LSU, you go back to 2019, Joe Burrow, Ja'Marr Chase, Justin Jefferson, that dynamic offense. But at the end of the day, it's still LSU. It's still the SEC. And ground and pound is something they will never move.
And he takes it all the way to the end zone. Touchdown, Bayou Bengals. He just breaks away and takes it to the house from distance. That's an elite running back type of play.
You know, when he got out into the open field, I didn't know if he had the speed to take that thing all the way to the house, but he does. That's next level speed.
But they'll try to add to the lead now with the PAT. Extra point makes it a 28-0 lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they get set to send this one away. Kickoff fielded inside the 20. They get him down at the 33 after a solid return. Wake Forest sends the offense back out on the field now. They were held to a quick three and out last time. Looking to put together a positive drive here. First down here for this offense. Off the play fake, looking to throw. Let's it fly to the wideout. Incomplete. They cannot connect on the deep ball.
Well, it's an incompletion here, but I bet this secondary is going to play a little bit deeper just to make sure they don't get hit on any deep throws later in this game.
Getting set. Here's second down.
325.
Out of the shotgun, he'll hand it off. Offense been in reverse here. Now a long way to go to convert this third down. Dropping back, looking to throw for the first down. He's going to be brought down by that ferocious pass rush. Nice sack.
Well, the defense would not be denied on this play. They come up with a sack. Quarterback really didn't have much of a chance at all. Lucky he just held on to the ball.
The Demon Deacons will line up to boot it away. It's a rough drive for the offense. Punter comes on to boot it away. Bringing it back, it's Thomas. And the coverage team makes the stop on this return. That Bayou Bengals offense is back out on the field. First down, looking to throw the football. Fires it to the wideout. Incomplete, very lucky to avoid an interception there.
Pretty nice catch here, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, sometimes a little questionable, as we saw here.
Takes the handoff. It's Williams. The pickup is just the yards. Now it's third down and 7.
You know, in the RPO game, the quarterback's got to make really sound decisions on that read. Either give it when it's the right time, or you pull it out and make the throw. Here, I think he's kind of in that gray area, decides to hand it off, and at least picked up some positive yards.
Dropping back, it's Nussmeier. Testing the defense with a throw downfield. Trying to press the ball deep, but it's incomplete. They bring the punter onto the field now. This is a low liner. This won't go a long way. He'll call for the fair catch here. The Wake Forest offense back out on the field now. They're coming off a 3-and-out, looking to produce a positive drive here. And the first play of the drive now set up at the 27. Receiver in motion now. They flip it to him on the jet sweep. Eludes a tackle. He shreds the tackle. Tackle is made, but that's good for a first down of the 47. Offense coming to the line. They might have a chance for a couple more plays before we reach the end of the quarter. A pop pass on the jet sweep. Gets the first and still running. The defense able to bring him down to wrap up the first period of play. It's LSU on top as we take a break for the quarter. They jumped out to an early lead in that opening period. Let's take a quick look at the stats so far. And as we flip the field and begin quarter number 2, we'll see if they can continue to build this lead. This offense has gotten going at long last. It's another 1st and 10. Again, thrown out of the RPO, and it's complete.
Defenses all around the country have got to do a better job of keeping an eye on these little guys from the slot. They can dismantle a defense with their speed and quickness in the open space.
Gonna run it. It's Claiborne. Finding space at the 20. And they tackle him, but not before he picks up the first. And the Demon Deacons come to the line to start a fresh set of downs. And at first down, they go right back to him. They pick up 4, so 2nd down and 6 coming up.
Well, another short game for this offense on the ground, and you got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They have really negated that aspect of this offense the entire first half and really making them one-dimensional. And if that doesn't change, I don't know how they get back into this game.
So here we go, 3rd down in the red zone, the kind of play that decides football games. The sack in the play could not escape the pass rush.
Finally, the defense is able to come up with a play on this drive. Let's face it, this offense has been able to put things together. Quarterback's had a nice drive, but finally, great job of getting the pressure and getting after that quarterback.
So the decision is to not go for it, but settle for three. Here comes the field goal team. Knocks that one right down the middle.
Well, Chris, it's a nice kick here to polish off that drive with at least 3 points up on the board.
So after coming away with three in that drive, the kickoff team is out. So no return here. He takes a knee in the end zone, and they'll begin the drive at the 25. Okay, so here comes the LSU offense back on the field. They're coming off a quick three and out, so looking to put something together on this drive with a little more urgency. Tackle behind the line, it's a loss of two. After a first down loss, it's second and long from the 23. Looking for some space, it's Williams. Breaking free at the 35. Heads out of bounds after a solid gain, more than enough to pick up a first down. Just pounding away for another big gain, Kirk. You wonder if this defense is beginning to lose its will a little bit.
I think they are losing their will. You can tell by the way they're tackling. It's been a very impressive performance by this offense and by this running back. You got to believe they're just...
Oh, and he's got it down inside the 20. Takes it all the way to the house. Touchdown, Tigers.
Boy, we see more and more of this in college football. If you get the right guy in that slot, they can win the one-on-one matchups. You take some chances. Here they got the matchup that they wanted and hit it for the touchdown.
And now the try here for the extra point. PAT is good as they build on this big lead. Kickoff team is on the field. Let's see if they give the returner a chance to bring this one back. And the return starts from inside the 20. Tackle at the 22. Good job by the coverage team. Sends the offense back out on the field now. Last time out, they moved the ball well, but had to settle for a chip shot field goal. Tackle behind the line. It's a loss of two.
I mean, Chris, you have to admire this offense. They continue to try to sprinkle in the run game, even though it's not been able to really get established. But they're not just becoming one-dimensional. You got to respect that, and hopefully at some point it'll pay off.
So from the 21-yard line, it's now second and long. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. Nowhere to run up the middle.
Tell you, this defense continues to just be physical. It's a line of scrimmage. Offense can't do anything on the ground, and by doing that, this defense is allowing their defensive front to get pressure on the quarterback. Every time they drop back to throw, they become a one-dimensional offense.
On third down, he drops to throw. Can't hold on. Good defensive play brings up a fourth down.
Boy, this is all about the defense here. Nice stop here on third down, but really it's about trying to get this offense behind the sticks. Once you get them behind the sticks, you can mix up your coverages, really affect the quarterback's eyes and disrupt the timing and the rhythm of what the offense is trying to do. Now we've got another big fourth down coming up.
Good effort by the return man. They get him down, but that's a solid gain in the return. And here comes that LSU offense back onto the field. So they begin the drive here in the final 3 minutes of the half. Dropping back, it's Nussmeier. Throws a bullet deep down the right side. They're not gonna get him. He's in. Touchdown, LSU. Well, a touchdown to a wide open man. What in the world was going on the defensive side of that?
What was the defense thinking here? You can't let a player roam free like that. They just completely forgot about him and gifted him a touchdown.
PAT. And the PAT is good as they continue to pull away even more. Now the kickoff team is out on the field. And it's caught from inside the 20. Stopped at the 22. That's pretty solid coverage there. Wake Forest offense back out on the field now. This group is coming off a quick three and out. Can they put something together in this drive? So the first play of the drive coming up here, under 3 minutes to play before half. First play of the drive, he looks left for a completion. And he will be stuffed for no gain. Offense getting set up. Here's second down. And he drops back in the gun. He's running out of time here. It's incomplete. He was hit as he threw that time. And now third down coming up. They come to the line. A long way to go for the first down, but needing this crucial conversion right now. The pocket breaking down. And the sack is made. That's a nice play there by the sophomore.
I can't believe the amount of pressure this defense is getting on this quarterback. Sack after sack. Boy, you got to think about changing things up. Snap count, the scheme, anything at all to help this offensive line. They're overmatched so far in this game.
Gets the kick away from his own end zone. On the return, it's Thomas. He's brought down, but a good effort to make something of that return.
Got it.
We've reached the two-minute warning here. Let's see if this offense can build on this big lead before halftime. And he's got his man open downfield. Tackle made after a big game.
Chris, this guy has a big-time arm. He just zipped the ball in there. You know, you can sometimes show your arm strength in other ways than just bombing it deep.
Looking for six. Catch made in the end zone. Touchdown, Bayou Bengals.
Hey, Chris, the threat of these receivers to the outside really did a nice job of opening up the interior. And the quarterback reads that, sees that he's got the post wide open to the tight end, makes a great throw for that touchdown.
Now the try here for the extra point. And the kick is up and good. They tack on a point to their lead. Kickoff team is on the field to boot this one away. Kickoff is fielded inside the 20. Not much on the return. They'll stop him at the 24. Good coverage. Wake Forest sends the offense back out on the field now. We're in a hole here before they have a chance to regroup at halftime. Let's see if they can cut into this big lead. The sure hands, it's Green. Defense reacts quickly, a very short gain on the play. The Demon Deacons will hustle to the line to run the hurry-up offense. Quarterback looking to pass here on second down. Fires it to the wideout. Here's a wide-open receiver complete. The stop is finally made, but it's a big gain. Stopped at the 49. And a timeout is called, important stage late here in the second quarter. Makes the catch. It's Claiborne. You get him down quickly, not much of a gain in that completion. Offense operating at high tempo now, no huddle. They look to throw it here on second down. The pass rush closing in. Offense stops the clock with their second timeout to talk strategy. The punter has been very busy so far. Can they finally convert here on third down? To throw, it's Bachmeier. Defense is coming after him. Going to try to use his legs here. Zero running room. Stopped right at the line of scrimmage. And the Demon Deacons will bring their punt team onto the field.
Boy, the defense does a good job of pressuring the quarterback, but really impressed with the quarterback's effort. Not only does he pull out of that, but he's able to get back close to the line of scrimmage.
Now they finally stop him, and he found a nice lane in that return. Puts the start of the drive in a good position. That wasn't alert enough, didn't get the playoff. That'll cost him 5 yards. And the delay of game penalty will push the offense back 5. The offense comes back out there. Not much time left. Perhaps just time for a couple plays before the half. Another delay of game penalty. What in the world is going on with this offense? Quarterback unaware of the play clock. That'll cost them 5. First down play call. How aggressive will it be? Quick pass. Here comes a jet sweep. And the runner scoots out of bounds after gaining some decent yardage.
Boy, I'm a big fan of that jet sweep motion like that. It really forces the defense to stretch them out horizontally and can create some vertical seams for this offense. They got some positive yards. Didn't quite get the first down, but I'll tell you what they've done. Planted a seed on this defense, and they better defend this style of play moving forward.
They bring him down. That's a very solid game, but still well short of the first down. And that will do it for the first half here. Kevin Connors now has our halftime update.
Guys, time for everyone inside that stadium to take a deep breath and digest what we just saw. And it'd be easy to say these two offenses are glad we've hit halftime based on their respective performances. It would also be accurate. Turnovers and sacks have told the story so far. And you gotta believe the play calling has been the issue, right? Time to shred those game plans and just get back to basics. Either way, it's time to find out. Back to the best in the biz for the start of this third quarter.
And they'll kick it off to begin the second half. Kickoff fielded inside the 20. Not much on the return. They'll stop him at the 24. Good coverage. The Wake Forest offense back out on the field now. First play of the second half is a handoff. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of 2.
But how about this defense? Just so physical against the run. These guys have not been able to do anything on the ground, and it's because of that defensive line and those linebackers taking away the run game.
They flip it to him on the jet sweep. And the sophomore able to bring him down quickly.
Man, that jet sweep action puts so much pressure on a defense. You get so locked in on the ball attacking you downhill. But when offenses sprinkle this kind of offense in, it stretches this defense out wide and can create some vertical seams for big plays.
Scanning the field, it's Bachmeyer. Quick throw to the left side, and it's intercepted. Beautiful timing there. Jukes to get past a man. And he'll be taken down, but after a good return.
Boy, would this quarterback love to have this one back. They're trying to work themselves back into this game here in the second half, and the defense comes up with a big turnover that could be the nail in the coffin.
And that Bayou Bengals offense is back out on the field. And he's going to fling it deep, going for it all here. Oh, and it's batted down by the defense. Great play to deny a touchdown. Offense lines up for a second down play off the incompletion. Quarterback looking to connect with the receiver here.
Well, Chris, the offense takes a
touchdown, Tigers! To stretch the lead, the route is on. Well, no surprise from offense this good. Short field, quick touchdown.
Yeah, you get into the red zone, though, there's a tendency to want to get conservative. I love that the offensive coordinator and the quarterback kept attacking until they came away with 7 points.
And they'll set up now for the extra point try. The extra point is good. They stretch the lead a little bit more. Kickoff team has come on the field now to send this one away. And the return starts from inside the 20. Not much on the return. They'll stop him at the 24. Good coverage. Wake Forest sends the offense back out on the field now. The last possession ended in an interception. Let's see if they continue to trust this quarterback in the passing game. From the shotgun, here's an inside give.
You know, in an era that we live in right now, everybody wants to spread the field around, try to create space, try to create one-on-one matchups, and the defense is countered over the years by trying to play out wide. But here's a great example. The defense has the ability to play wide, but still be solid at the line of scrimmage, not give up big run plays.
They bring him down, but that's a good play. Moves the ball to the 39.
You know, offensive linemen are just a certain breed. They're always going to do their job, no matter who's back there carrying the ball. I tell you what, they have a little bit more confidence when the person that's carrying the ball can break off some big-time runs. That makes them block just a little bit harder, knowing what he's potentially capable of doing.
And he's tackled, but only after picking up a first down. The Demon Deacons come to the line to start a fresh set of downs. On first down, it's play action. Quick throw, catch made on the out route. Tackle made after a nice pickup on the play.
Well, this is called settling down in a zone defense, just kind of finding that soft spot. So not only does this tight end show that he's got great athletic ability and great size, here he shows that he understands coverage by sitting down in that hole, giving the quarterback a nice target, able to pick up that first down.
Offense getting set. It's second down. And the ball is handed off out of the shotgun. And they'll bring him down after just a short pickup. Not going to be easy here. Backed up a long way to go for a first down. And he'll drop back here on third down. Pressure is coming. The QB throws his third pick of the day. So a great return following the pick. They're finally able to get him down.
Chris, that's back-to-back drives now that this offense has thrown interceptions. They've got to be able to regroup on the sideline, adjust their schemes, maybe their personnel groupings and formations, try to find a new way to attack, because right now, this isn't working.
Okay, so here comes the LSU offense back on the field. First play of the drive, they come out throwing. He's looking deep here. This one is broken up and falls incomplete.
Now, the offensive coordinator told us before the game, they consider any one-on-one deep shot an advantage, but they couldn't connect on that try. Give credit to that defensive back, man. He played that perfectly.
To the air, it's Nussmeier. But the junior quarterback, inaccurate that time, threw it behind the receiver. So the offense getting set. This is not where you want to be against this defense. Third and long. Dropping back, looking to throw for the first down. Freshman introducing himself to the quarterback there.
Great call here going with that nickel defense, giving you more speed on the field on that third down and long. Nowhere to go. Gave the defensive line plenty of time to come up with that sack. And now it's fourth down and long.
And the punt team makes its way onto the field. Looking to kick it away for the second time. It's a low punt, won't travel very far. Returner decides to fair catch this. The Wake Forest offense back out on the field now. They had some good things going on the last drive, but it ended suddenly with the pick. Let's see what they can do here. This line getting set up. It's a first down play. It's a shotgun run call. Gain of 2 yards. Now it's second down and 8.
See, that's how you limit what an offense wants to do. This time, the defense just won the battle up front at the line of scrimmage, not giving up any big plays. Everybody's gap sound. It's really solid defense on that play.
And he's brought down, but they went backwards after the completion. Good work by the defense.
A couple things that really stood out to me here, Chris, on this nice play by the corner. Awareness to be able to see the wide receiver screen, and then the willingness to get involved and run support and make the tackle. Great play.
Bringing pressure. breaking free at midfield. The first down pickup tackled at the 45.
Man, nothing is more aggravating for a defensive coordinator than this right here. You've got him. You got a chance to make a play on him, take him out of his rhythm, but instead, this guy gets away from that pressure, tucks it, and picks up some big yards.
Ready up. Second and 10 here. Out of the shotgun, he hands it off. Tackled behind the line, it's a loss of two.
Chris, I'll be really honest with you. I don't know why they continue to try to run the football. I'm all about balance. I'm all about trying to make sure defense... and the throw. But at this point in the game, they haven't been able to run the ball. They're going to have to go through the air if they're
going to. He cannot escape the defense with a sack.
Well, that takes the wind right out of your sails. This offense is trying to find a way to get back into this game. And another pressure and a sack against their quarterback.
And the Demon Deacons will line up to kick it away. This is punt number 6. Get the ice bath ready for the punter. Running it back, it's Thomas. He's got some daylight turning on the speed. The return man flashing his elusive speed. They finally get him, but it's a big game. And here comes that LSU offense back onto the field. Last time was a quick 3-and-out. Can they get a drive going this time? Catch made wide open way downfield.
The defense is spread all over the field, creating some one-on-one matchups, and the quarterback makes them pay for it.
The defense better regroup after that big gainer. It's first and goal just outside the 5.
Lasso!
A pop pass on the jet sweep. Touchdown, LSU. And this one is getting ugly.
Well, that's a well-oiled machine right there. Everyone on this offense has been a star in their roles. And when they're rolling like this, it results in quick and positive results.
And now here comes the point after attempt. PAT is good as they build on this big lead. Now they get set to kick it away. And it's caught from inside the 20. Tackle at the 22. Good job by the coverage team. 3-4 sends the offense back out on the field now. Last possession, they were forced to kick it away. Can they finally get things going this time? Quick pass. Here comes a jet sweep. Moves the ball up to the 30. The offense will line up. Chance for a couple more plays before the end of the quarter. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw it. He'll take a deep shot. Trying to go very deep there. Good effort. And now it's third down.
Most offensive coaches will be happy taking those 50-50 shots against man coverage. But I'm curious to see if they're going to test this DB again after that coverage.
On third down, it's a handoff. The defense gets him behind the line as time expires in the third period. It's LSU on top as we take a break for the quarter. This has been a beatdown, and the stats at the end of 3 reflect that. One quarter to play of what has been a beatdown so far. The Demon Deacons will bring their punt team onto the field. And the returner brought down by the coverage team there.
Well, this returner is about to get an earful, but at least the coach isn't as mad as they would have been if they ended up losing the ball.
They flip it to him on the jet sweep. Has the first down still on the move. Worked out of bounds, but it's another big game. This air attack, no problem moving the ball up and down the field today.
Matt, and with that completion right there, this quarterback now has gone over 300 yards in this game. What a day.
Big guys up front lined up. It's first down. Solid gain. Moves the ball to the 36.
Nice solid run here by this back. Did a nice job just kind of finding that lane. Pick up some positive yards there on first and 10.
A pop pass on the jet sweep. And the freshman brings him down quickly. Crucial third down play coming up.
Let's go.
Looking to pass. It's Nussmeier. Makes the throw across the middle of the field. He makes the grab. They bring him down, but an explosive play by this offense. Big game. This LSU offense is moving quickly down the field. Quick pass. Here comes a jet sweep. They stop him after a six-yard gain. So second and four.
You know, the good thing about this play is it's not an explosive play, but it really gives you a chance now to be able to pick up a first down here on this next play.
Second down after that run on the previous play. They flip it to him on the jet sweep. Breaks into the clear. It's a sprint. It's a big gain before he goes out of bounds. It'll move the sticks more than enough for a first down.
The defense has got to do a much better job here of adjusting to the pre-snap motion. They just kind of stayed in place, and it gave the receiver plenty of room there to make a nice play.
A pop pass on the jet sweep. He's got some room. Can he get there? Force out of bounds after a nice game. The offense is knocking on the door with a first and goal. The offense sets up in scoring position with a new set of downs. Quick pass. Here comes a jet sweep. Touchdown, Bayou Bengals. And the beatdown continues.
This is just complete domination in every phase. Offense, defense, special teams. Fun to see for this team. Unfortunate on the other side.
Try the extra point. And the kick is up and good. They tack on a point to their lead. Here's the kickoff team. Let's see if they give the returner an opportunity to bring this back. Kickoff is fielded inside the 20. And the coverage team brings him down at the 26. Looks like a player is down injured at that last play. We'll take a timeout while they check it out. The Wake Forest offense back out on the field now. They were held to a quick three and out last time, looking to put together a positive drive here. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. It's picked off again, the fourth for this QB today. Touchdown, Tigers! And the defense joins the party with a pick six.
Great job here by the defense coming up with yet another play. Boy, they are just pouring it on today, dominating in every phase.
And now they'll set up for the point after. And the PAT is good as they continue to pull away even more. Here's the kickoff team now, set to boot this one away. Kickoff fielded inside the 20. Not much on the return. They'll stop him at the 24. Good coverage. Wake Forest sends the offense back out on the field now. They have got to bounce back on this possession after throwing a pick six last time out here. Quick throw to his receiver. And he finds a wide open receiver. They forgot about him downfield. They bring him down, but the veteran quarterback shows off that trademark arm strength. First down play call coming up. How aggressive will it be? Back to throw. It's Bachmeier. Looking for the wideout. And the senior quarterback puts a little bit too much on the throw.
Chris, we're all guilty of this. We all look at the big plays, the quarterbacks, the offense, how many points, how many yards. Sometimes we overlook the most important aspect of the game, the offensive line.
You've got to do a good job consistently protecting the quarterback. It all comes down to the offensive line. And here, they hurry the quarterback, and they blow up the play.
Back to throw again. Let's just go quickly. And that is interception number 5 as the nightmare performance continues. They get him down after a short return, but the takeaway sets up the offense at the 43.
I just don't think there's anything else you can do as a play caller. You've got to be able to throw the ball downfield. You just got to hope that your quarterback and receivers can execute when the defense knows it's coming. Here, the interception cost them.
And that Bayou Bengals offense is back out on the field. They were clicking last time. Great protection. The pitch and catch was solid. Right down for a touchdown. He's past the marker and still going. And a big game before he goes out of bounds. The offense keeps churning, gets a fresh set of downs. See what the call is on first and 10. Offense moving receivers around now before the snap. They flip it to him on the jet sweep. Great cut there. Man heads out of bounds after a decent game.
You know, a lot of times these types of plays either go for nothing or they can go for a huge chunk of yards. Here they do a nice job of getting it to the outside, turning it upfield, and ended up getting a nice gain on it.
Breaks clear, end zone ahead. Touchdown, LSU. Stretching the lead, this one is getting ugly.
Boy, they just continue to do everything right. This offense has looked outstanding from the opening series all the way up to this point, doing everything that's asked of them. Great execution, and put another touchdown up on the board.
Looks like he didn't get the snap off in time. That'll cost him 5 yards. Pretty easy call for the head coach. He will accept that penalty, of course. So they'll try to add to the lead now with the PAT. The extra point is good, and they stretch the lead a little bit more. Getting set to kick the ball off now. And the return starts from inside the 20. One down at the 29. That's when they'll start the drive. Fresh set of downs for the offense. First down. To throw, it's Bachmeyer. Running out of time. Nowhere to go. The ball knocked loose. Defense recovers the fumble. Big takeaway.
Oh, just a costly turnover here for this offense. Last thing they wanted to see is put this ball on the ground. And really, any chance of getting back into this game is lost.
Okay, so here comes the LSU offense back on the field. This group has been clicking. They've really built momentum. Can the defense make adjustments? Come up with a stop here. A pop pass on the jet sweep. Got space looking for the end zone here. Touchdown, Bayou Bengals. And the route is on.
Chris, you're talking about having a day. This offense just goes out. They're not even looking at the scoreboard. They're just going out, executing the play call, and continuing to put points on the board.
They're set now to try the PAT. And the kick is up and good. They tack on a point to their lead. Kickoff team on the field getting set now. And it's caught from inside the 20. And they stop him at the 23. That's solid coverage. First down here. Time for one more play before the clock stops with the two-minute warning. On first and 10, looking to throw. Let's it fly out of the wideout. Oh, and he dropped it. Very uncharacteristic play by this wide receiver. Second down. Second down here. Time for perhaps just one more play before the two-minute warning. He's back to throw again on second and 10. And he's brought down. Offense going backwards with the sack. We reach the two-minute warning here. This offense needing to score and then get the football back. Now in third and very long, looking to throw. But they don't connect. It's incomplete, and it brings up fourth down.
Boy, this offense has really struggled today, Chris, when it comes to throwing the football. They have dug themselves a huge hole. They're not going to have any chance of coming back. And I think one thing about this is you wonder where you go from here. You're hoping to make a play or two to give yourself a belief that things can get better, but it's just been a disastrous day for the offense.
They'll kick it away here. He's got an opening. Watch out. He's got great speed. The returner is brought down. Gets a start with the next drive. And here comes that LSU offense back onto the field. What a satisfying feeling for this team. Just run out the clock and let the celebration begin. Didn't quite get the playoff in time. It'll be delay of game.
Delay of game. Offense.
Quarterback lost track of the play clock, and it'll cost the offense five. First down here for this offense. Hand off to the back. They'll keep the clock moving.
That back just had nowhere to go. I gotta give credit to the defense and the run fits on that play.
Quick pass. Here comes a jet sweep. Inside the 45. Oh, and he's in the clear now. It's a foot race. Huge play. Moves the ball down inside the 10-yard line. It's first and goal.
And I love how they're using the receiver here in motion. With a weapon like this, you just get him the football. Simple throw for the quarterback. He's got all that speed built up. You get him the ball out there in space with a couple blockers, and you get big plays like this right here.
So that huge gain quickly sets up a first and goal just inside the 10. Trying the run, it's Williams. Ball carrier brought down at the 4. Offense in great scoring position here.
I know this defense worked very hard at halftime to come up with answers on how to try to slow down this running back after
touchdown Tigers. To stretch the lead, the route is on.
That's another touchdown for these guys. Man, they have had a day that you dream about. Whether it's the quarterback, the running back, the receivers, the offensive line, the entire unit has been dominant.
Kicking team out for the PAT try. PAT is good as they build on this big lead. The kickoff team on the field now as they get set to send this one away. Kickoff is fielded inside the 20. Stop at the 22. That's pretty solid coverage there. The Wake Forest offense back out on the field now. This thing is so out of hand, all you can do now is play for a little shred of pride. Okay. defense out for the first play of the drive, beginning at the 22.
Easy.
Here comes a first down pass attempt. That one falls incomplete. Good defensive play brings up second down.
How about the defense today? They have played so well. I think the defensive coordinator put together a great plan. His kids clearly understood their scheme because they have been aggressive and attacking all game long.
Looking to throw, it's Bachmeier. And the junior able to get home with the sack.
This defense has been lights out today. Great job once again applying pressure on this quarterback. This poor quarterback, he doesn't know what he has seen today. Not able to get anything going to be able to try to compete in this game. They're down big, and now they're just hoping for that clock to run out.
So a tricky situation here. Third and very long inside your own 20. How much of a risk do you take? You know, this... very aggressive at this moment. Here's another interception, but we're losing track. Takes the pick to the end zone. Touchdown, LSU.
What a job by this defense to get this pick six. And on the other side, what are you thinking? Throwing the football with a nice lead with under 2 minutes to go. Now we've got a one possession game if they make this extra point.
Here's the point after attempt. And the PAT is good as they continue to pull away even more. Kickoff team is on the field. Let's see if they give the returner a chance to bring this one back. Kickoff fielded inside the 20. Not much on the return. They'll stop him at the 24. Good coverage. Big Four sends the offense back out on the field now. This has been a long afternoon for this offense. All that's left, got to get some consolation points here. He's running out of time here. One last pass attempt falls incomplete, and that will wrap up this game. Well, this one ended up being a blowout, but they get the W, but they also make a pretty strong statement here today.
Yeah, I thought this game would be a lot closer, at least closer than how things ended up. But give credit to this team for coming out with a good game plan and just dominating the game.
And that is going to wrap it up. We enjoyed this one here. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Chris Fowler, and this has been another presentation of EA Sports College Football.